Hi guys, and welcome back to another IBRACORP video. Thanks for coming back and checking out the channel, it's a pleasure to have you here. Today, we're dissecting the latest updates from Unraid 6.12.8 and unveiling the new licensing model that's stirring up the community. Whether you're a seasoned Unraid user or new to the platform or you're thinking about checking it out, then you'll want to stick around for this. Without further ado, let's dive in. So guys, I've reviewed the patch notes for this latest update, 6.12.8, and I'll put the link down in the description for you to follow through if you want to have a read. But today's video is going to help you digest some of that information and hopefully you find it helpful. So here's the top 10, starting with number 1, Docker security enhancements. Kicking things off with security, Unraid has patched Docker to safeguard against the latest vulnerabilities. This move underscores Unraid's commitment to protecting data and ensuring our containers run smoothly without compromising security. That's a really important update, guys. If you are running Docker containers or you even have Docker running at all, it's really important that you are patching this as soon as possible. There are two massive vulnerabilities that get patched with this update, so definitely important to make sure that you do that as soon as reasonably practicable. A critical fix in this update also addresses an issue with array drives showing as unformatted after a reboot, particularly for drives with non-standard partition layouts. So this update is a relief for users who have faced data loss scares, reinforcing the stability of our storage setup. That was an annoying bug, so if you had something coming up in unformatted, unassigned devices, this should help with that issue. Number 3, with networking and VM enhancements. On the networking front, Unraid has stepped up its game with improvements to VM management and network performance, something that we've had various reports from the community about, especially when it comes to Realtek drivers and the like. It also includes enhanced support for macOS Time Machine over SMB, ensuring our backups are seamless and reliable. So again, a big upgrade there with enhanced support for macOS Time Machine. That's pretty big, especially for those using Macs in their environment. This should really help the process and ensure stability between your network and those virtual machines. For number 4 on the list, it's improved smart monitoring. So for those keeping a close eye on their SSDs and NVMe drives, Unraid's enhanced smart monitoring tools now provide better self-tests and endurance tracking. This proactive approach to drive health can help prevent data loss before it happens. So make sure you're using those tests. We've got the ability here to run those tests now, as you can see. Just go to your main, pick the drive that you want to run the smart test on, being an SSD or NVMe. We can click on that, go to self-test, and then you can run those tests here. Number 5 on the list, new user interface improvements. In 6.12.8, Unraid introduces user interface enhancements, making navigation smoother and more intuitive. These improvements aim to enhance our user experience, making it easier to manage our system. You can see from a variety of different UI improvements over the last few versions makes it so much easier to get to where we need to go and providing critical information where we need it. It also helps streamline a lot of the approach, and a lot of the questions I get around customization can be found under settings and display settings. If you haven't come through this area yet, it's really important you do. You can really customize the look and feel of your server just to the way you like it. Maybe you like the way we do it. I know a few people have asked, this is where all those settings are. And you can even copy what we've got here if you prefer, and that should make your life a little bit easier. Number 6 on the list is better plugin and app management. With this update, managing plugins and apps becomes more streamlined thanks to optimizations in the web UI. This means quicker access to updates and smoother installations, keeping our system up to date with less hassle. So you can see here our ability to update everything at once where necessary. Since I've just upgraded to 6.12.8, it's probably a good idea we now do this. Number 7, enhanced disk performance. Unraid has also focused on disk performance, implementing changes that enhance read-write speeds and reduce latency. For users with heavy storage demands, this translates to more efficient data access and improved overall system performance. So that's a majority of the updates in this patch. There's obviously more detail in the changelog, which I'll put in the description. But one very important recommendation I'd like to make, and it's also made in the changelog by Spencer J, is to make sure you've got the Fix Common Problems plugin installed. This is a really handy plugin, and it will give you the ability to quickly and easily identify any issues with setup. Make sure you have that running, give it a scan, and see what it tells you about where you can improve or make any changes. It's especially important after you make any updates to your server because it'll help scan across and check for any changes. So here's one, for example, Docker patch not installed. Due to a change in Docker executable, Docker run errors may result in certain circumstances. So then they pretty much tell us to make sure we grab Docker patch 6.12.8 from the apps tab. Let's jump over there and here's the patch. So please make sure you update that if you've moved versions to 6.12.8 and using Docker. Then of course, run through your QA process and ensure your Docker containers are running as you expect them to. And now to probably the most talked about part is number 8, introduction of new license types. So big news on the licensing front, Unraid is introducing 3 new license types, Starter, Unleashed, and Lifetime. This change aims to offer more flexibility and options to users at various levels, from small home setups to large scale operations. You can see the blog post here from LimeTech themselves on the forums, and they've also got it on the blog post too, as well as in the Unraid Uncast show. So number 9 out of this list is grandfathering existing licenses. Are you worried about your current license? Fear not. Unraid is committed to grandfathering in all basic, plus, and pro license holders. This means we'll continue to enjoy updates and the flexibility to upgrade our license as before without any impact from the new pricing model. So a big, big praise to LimeTech for making that very clear right from the start. Those who have supported Unraid over the years and have already purchased their licenses, we really don't want to have to be facing something like a subscription model or be moved to that model, I should say, when we've already paid and supported the process. Number 10, to finish things off, is an optional update extension fee. So a notable change within the new Starter and Unleashed licenses is the introduction of an optional extension fee for software updates after the first year. This provides users with the choice to receive updates for an additional year, ensuring flexibility and control over their Unraid experience. Like I said, just to be clear, for those who are already on a Basic Plus and Pro license, we won't be affected. This is going to be something that they're looking at moving forward. So just keep that in mind though, if you haven't had the opportunity to do so, you can. So another important and final note is Pro Keys will still be offered. They might change the name, as it says here, from Pro to Lifetime. And that is one of the minor details they're still working on. So that means there's still going to be a lifetime sort of option that you can purchase. But just keep those changes in mind if you're looking down the track and deciding to do something later on. And there you have it, the top updates in Unraid 6.12.8 and a look at the new licensing model set to provide more options and flexibility for us, the users. Whether you're optimizing your current setup or planning your next big build, Unraid continues to evolve to meet our needs, which is something we really like to see in the industry. Did you find this rundown helpful? Give us a like, subscribe for more tech insights, and hit that notification bell to stay updated. If you've got thoughts or questions about these updates, drop a comment below. Until next time, we'll see you in the next IBRACORP video.